Hello everyone, this is Morand. Welcome back to Miranda. So here we are, guys. I actually noticed something. I didn't mention anything about this wall design here previously, but you guys have probably seen it already in some of the previous videos. But anyway, a little while back I was trying to figure out what I want to do with this design. And I decided to try out some chiseled blocks. So these are actually these blocks here are chiseled stone bricks, and I really love how they look. And I also wanted to use some Twilight Forest fireflies that I had from the previous world, and I think it works okay. I actually really like that. So I think we are actually going to use this sort of wall design more here in the basement. I really want to use some more of those blocks. But anyway, guys, before I start babbling anymore, you will have to excuse me if I sound a little bit off. I've been sick with a stomach flu for quite a few days, so I'm slowly getting back to recording and all that. But anyway, here we go. And we are here in the basement because we have some puppies to name. And first of all, thanks so much, guys, for the name suggestions that I've received in the last few episodes. So let's see. Oh, right. I put them here. All right. So we actually have name suggestions for bulldogs, corgis, boxers, and the raccoons that we found. So let's see. Where did I put the bulldogs? Huskies. Boxers. Okay, there's one boxer. That is a corgi. Okay, let's see, Newfoundland bulldog. And those are the raccoons. Okay, we can do that in just a bit. And I need to make sure that I have some... Okay, not that. That I have some biscuits for all the pups. Okay, there we go. There we go, that should make things a little bit easier. And there's the analyzer too, just in case, since we need to name those. So I'm so sorry I don't have your guys' names here in my little notepad who gave these name suggestions. I do know that the boxer name came from Kate, and there, I believe the same person also suggested both of the bulldog name and the corgi name. So thank you so much for that. And let's go ahead and check out the boxer first. There we go. And buddy. Hi, buddy. Okay, let's tame this guy. He's very fast. Okay. Puppy. Puppy. Puppy, what are you doing? Oh my goodness gracious. He's just jumping here. Okay, so he's apparently tame, but I can't name him for some reason. But his tail is wagging. Okay, so can I can sit you down, okay? Yeah, I think this puppy is a little bit glitched here, but if needed, I will redo this off camera. But anyway, thanks so much for the name suggestion, Kate, for the boxer. And we will name this puppy Diesel in honor of a puppy who Kate took care of. So there we go. This is Diesel. And yeah, the name is not showing up. I need to fix that later. But thanks so much for that. And let's see. There's a corgi. Let's tame this guy next. Okay. Can I give you some can I give you some biscuits, please? Oh my gosh, these dogs are driving me crazy. Silly puppy. Okay. Thank you. Let's actually go here. I feel like this is going to be a little bit easier. Hopefully. Maybe. Who knows? Let's block this. Okay, we can't. I don't have enough blocks to do that. Dang it! Okay, let's go here. We are going to tame this puppy here. It's going to be a little bit easier, hopefully. Okay, here we go. There we go. And the corgi is going to be named Peanut. So there we go. And let's see. Is your tail wagging? It is. Wonderful. Okay, so there's Peanut. Let's take her downstairs. This is getting so. Oh, actually, I'm silly. I'm so silly. Okay, let's go. Let's go and name the other guys too. And the bulldog is what? Okay, never mind. I'm being silly. That's the American bulldog who we saved from the ravine. And let's tame this guy. Hi, puppy. There we go. And this puppy is going to be called Crispy. Because he was so close to lava in the previous episode and was about to die from that. And he's very, very energetic. Okay, there we go. And so we also have. Let's see. Did I, oh, dang it. I didn't even take the raccoons with me. I'm so silly. But anyway, let's go down. Let's go downstairs and take the raccoons. There we go. And I also I actually already know what I want to do with the raccoons. I'm actually going to release these guys in my garden a little bit later when I make a little bit more progress. Should I even tame these guys? I feel like I read somewhere that you can tame the raccoons. And like the same way that you tame dogs. But I have no idea if you can actually breed them. So I guess that's something that we need to figure out. But let's see. Oh my goodness, you are so adorable. Can I tame you? No. Oh, interesting. Okay. Yeah, so these guys cannot be tamed, apparently. Interesting. Very interesting. Okay. So we need to use some name tags. That's totally fine. Let's go here. Let's go here. Where are my name tags? We need to reuse that. And that. Okay, there we go. And the raccoons are going to be named Lena and Danny. And I have no idea where these names come from. I imagine that possibly some sort of movie or something. So if you know, I'm so sorry, I don't remember who left this name suggestions, but please let me know where these names came from. I'm very curious about that. So let's actually go back. This is so silly. I'm just running around with my axe at this point. But anyway, here we go. Let's go ahead and name these guys. So this is Lena. And the other one is Danny. Wonderful. So thank you so much for all the name suggestions, guys. I really, really appreciate it. As you guys can see, we have a lot of puppies that need to be named. So definitely, if you have name suggestions, please let me know in the comments and we can name those guys too. But yeah, for the most part, I think we are actually going to go with some video game themed names. Danny, didn't mean to release you. Okay, let's put those guys there and there we go. So Peanut can. Where are you going, puppy? Okay, sit there. And let's see. There we go. Diesel. There you go. So he needs to be healed. He's healing himself right now. Hopefully. There we go. All right, I'm just all over the place with the puppies. Let's put this. Okay, now he's healing. Wonderful. Let's put this away. And things should be okay now. Oh, by the way, guys, I actually while I was playing off camera, I found another artifact tower, and there were four artifacts in that one tower. I've never seen so many of them in the same one. So we found a fire protection porky iron helm. This one definitely made me laugh out loud. And also a damage resist diamond chest plate of armor. Damage resistance, interesting. And this is very interesting, the excavator's gold trinket digs big holes. And I figured that this is something that we are going to test out together. I didn't try it out before, so that's going to be exciting. And also, floating gold wand of the sun provides illumination, extra traps from ores, and allows sneaking on air when hailed. This is actually pretty interesting. Okay, let's actually sit down. Okay, I will show you how this works. It's so interesting. Okay, so I'm sneaking, and I'm sneaking in the air right now. This is so interesting. No idea how I would use this. Maybe building or something like that. But yeah, it's definitely very, very, very interesting artifacts. I was happy that I found those. But let's go ahead and put this away. And we might as well actually try that out. But the focus on this episode was actually to rename those puppies and to go and do some work at the marketplace area. But I'm really, really excited to try this out. Let's go and try this out. I really want to see how that works. Okay, so let's go to the strip mine, actually. I haven't really shown this to you guys in ages, since, you know, it's strip mining. You guys know how it goes. But anyway, let's go here. And there's a lot of sheep here, as always. I really, really need to do something with this pathway here. Alright, let's go here. And I really want to see how this works. I'm kind of scared though. So, this is going to be interesting. I'm sure that I'm going to end up dying with this or something. But let's go here maybe. Okay, I think we are actually too low now. Should I just try it here? Let's dig just a little bit here, so that we have some space, and try this out, okay? Are you guys ready? It doesn't do anything. I'm right-clicking it, I'm left-clicking it. Oh, I see. I'm being silly. I'm being totally silly. I see. Okay, yeah, so it kind of works like a pick. So how big is that? Let's try it here. Oh, that's fantastic. That's fantastic. I'm speechless. All right, okay. Let's light this area up a little bit and fix these stairs. That's fantastic. That's going to help a lot, even though it doesn't really have too much durability. So that's going to be a problem. But anyway, yeah, very interesting. Let's just move on, shall we? I'm getting so distracted by all these things. Oh my goodness. But anyway, yeah, before I get too distracted, let's go to the marketplace area and continue working there. So I will see you in just a bit. All right, guys. So I have actually made a little bit of progress here. I figured out what I want to do with this market stalls here. And I think this is the general design that we are going to use. Some chiseled wood, jungle wood and oak. I think that's going to work best. And I also moved the NPC here already, the blacksmith, and I hit his hideous name. Hello, hello. And I was also testing out some new things that I haven't really used ever before. So this is the fancy sign. Let's see. The fancy sign that comes with Bibliocraft, I'm pretty sure. There we go. And you can place items here. So I placed a iron ingot here. And we can also place some other things here. We can switch the text size here and do all kinds of awesome things. So that's exciting. And I think we are going to use this fancy signs for the market stalls. And I do need to figure out what other traits I want to add here to the blacksmith. Not sure yet, but anyway, he's here now already. And I will need to add some items here, like some iron ingots, maybe some of those soul stones, maybe some quartz ingots to, you know, showcase what items you can get from this guy. And here is the other stand, and this is going to be, I haven't set up any trades for this guy yet, but hello, this is our ice cream penguin, and this is actually something that I'm really, really excited about. A fun fact, in Finland, one of the most popular or the biggest ice cream brands is called Penguin. the brand is called Penguin, and it's the Penguin ice cream. So I figured that why not? We might as well bring the same concept here. So we have a penguin here selling ice cream. And these are the little coolers or the little freezers that we are going to use for the ice cream. And we are going to work on this today. So we are going to do some work with DaVinci mod. But anyway, the design is the same one. Like I said, that the general market stall idea that I figured out. So this is, we are going to use this for all the other ones here too. And there are probably not going to be as many market stalls, at least for now, than what I was originally thinking. We might actually end up moving one of those away. I did clear out one from this area already, because I'm actually kind of needing some more ideas what kind of market stalls we are going to have here. One of the suggestions, and definitely one of the things that I was originally thinking too, but I forgot it because I have so much in my mind. So thank you so much to the person who reminded me and suggested in the comments that we need a person who will sell dog food. So this is definitely going to be one of those market stalls here. It's going to be probably for the main food, like any of the toys and snacks and treats are not going to be probably sold here, but there's going to be another stall that will sell us like the biscuits that you will need to tame copious dogs and all that. So that's probably going to be another market stall here. And also some doggy toys. We do have some things here. Let's see. Like the throw bone here. This is something that we can sell here. Breeding bone. Interesting. All right. I haven't seen that before. And there's probably going to be a lot more things there too. I mean, we have the DaVinci mod installed, so we can custom make some little balls, some bones and whatnots for sale there. I'm really, really rusty with my English. So sorry about that, guys. But anyway, we're going to work on this today, and I completely forgot what I needed to do. Let's see. Oh my goodness, I'm just all over the place. Okay, I do have my shears, so that's good. Let's go here. I need to go and get some wool to be able to move forward with my idea what I want to do with the ice cream stand. So let's go here. I think we have some sheep here. Yes. So let's see. I need some dyes though. But anyway, let's get some wool. We don't need too much of it. That might be enough, actually. Okay, there we go. That's all that we need. And I need to go ahead and get some dye. So I probably have some dye on the other side, actually, now that I think of it. So let's go there. Hello, how are you guys doing? The house is packed, as always. Okay, let's go here. I'm pretty sure that I have some yellow at least, and I should have some, whoops, some green here too. Yes. Okay, and I feel like I did have some red too. Okay, that's not going to... Orange dye! Oh, that will actually work. Okay, that's fine. Awesome! Awesome, let's continue. So yeah, definitely let me know, guys, if you have ideas what kind of market stalls we could have here. Definitely the dog food salesman is going to be here. And... there could be any sort of market stalls here. We could have all kinds of things here. All right, so let's go ahead and have one of those. We don't really need too much of that. But to get us started, I think that's going to be fine. And let's place him here. Awesome. And let's see, where's my chisel thingy? There we go. Awesome. So my idea is that we will start using these little blocks to add some color for the fridge and to make it look like there's some ice cream packages in the fridge. So just some color variation and whatnot. And I really need to find some red dye. Let's see. Where is it? Oh, I'm full. Never mind. There we go. There we go. Let's take a few of these. Awesome. And we can add them here. So I actually, it's one block deep or one pixel deep right now. So I feel like we might actually need to make it a little bit deeper so that we can have some more space to work with. And I figured that the iron blocks might be the best thing to use. It kind of looks like a like a little fridge or a little freezer to me at least. So let's go ahead and remove some of these blocks here. Okay, there we go. Relax bike. Let's go here. Whoa, okay. Hi. For some reason, I am always getting so much lag in this area. I have no idea why. I don't know. I don't know what's up with that. But anyway, yeah, the idea is that we will have some... Actually, I need some white wool too. I'll just quickly toss this here because I don't need those. I need some more space. Okay, all the things go away. Thank you. Okay, that's a little bit better. Okay, so let's get some of these too. All right. Oh my goodness! Come here, puppy! What are you doing? What are you doing? What? Did I unseat you? I'm so confused right now. But anyway, I'm getting so distracted. Let's do this. Yeah, the idea is that we are going to have some little packages here that looks like it's ice cream. And maybe some more green. And some orange. Some yellow. There we go. And possibly some other colors, like red would be really awesome at this point. And the same goes here. So we can add some different color variations here, make it look a lot more fun, and sort of like these are ice cream packages here. So yeah, I like it. I really enjoy that. Okay, let's actually remove this and that. Yeah, I like that. And when we have some more color here, maybe some blue, some red or something like that, we can put them in between these colors, so it looks a little bit better. But I really enjoy this already. I really like this already. It kind of looks like this. Some ice cream packages there. Whoa. Okay, so what's with this lag? This is so confusing. My world never lags like this anywhere else but this area. That's so weird. Maybe it's all these torches that are all around the place. Not sure. But anyway, yeah. This is something that I really, really wanted to do in this episode. Let me know, guys, what you think about this. If you have any other suggestions, what we could add here. But I think for now it works the way that I want it to work. And let's see. We have a lot of ice creams here. And we can actually add all of these for this market stall. So that's going to be exciting. We have caramel, mint chocolate, strawberry, vanilla, spumoni ice cream, Neapolitan ice cream, pistachio, cherry ice cream, chocolate, of course. So it's going to be a lot of fun to have just these little random market stalls here. And when you guys download the world download eventually, you guys can also come here and do some trading, get some fun items, some food and whatnot. So it's going to be a lot of fun. But anyway, guys, I think we are actually about to end this episode. There was something that I really wanted to mention to you guys. I haven't really done any channel update sort of things in this series, but this is something that I really felt like I want to mention this in all of my series in case you guys haven't heard about this before. But with the recent changes on YouTube, it has been really challenging for me to continue with my channel in general, because basically, the support for all my series has dropped a lot, and this series sadly has been the one that has been taking the most hits with the views and all that. And that's because YouTube does not show all the videos in your subscription feed. Even though if you have subscribed to the channel, whatever channel that might be, if you are not interacting with the channel, and by interacting I mean leaving likes and comments, watching those videos doesn't even count at this point, sadly. So if you are not interacting with the channel, I mean not just my channel, but any channel that you like to watch on YouTube, that means that you are possibly not going to see all the videos, all the updates that come for the channel. And that means that I have lost a lot of support on all my series, and I need to do some work and do something in what I want to continue doing with the channel. I'm probably going to be switching a lot of content to streaming, so that it's going to be the main focus is going to be on streaming. But I really, really don't want to quit. I don't want to lose all my hope when it comes to the channel. But just in case you guys haven't heard about this before, Make sure that you will interact with the channels that you like to watch, because that can actually make it or break it, what comes to the channel. So definitely, if you are interested in watching my series, any of my series, or continuing to watch this series, if you enjoyed it, interact with the channel. Leave likes, leave comments, let me know that you are interested in watching these videos, and the most of all, let YouTube know that you want to continue watching this, because it has been a total nonsense what has been happening with YouTube recently. And it's not just me, it's basically everyone who's making content on YouTube, and it's a really tough time for all of us content creators. So I just felt like I want to mention in this series, I'm going to be recording some of my other series this week too, and I will probably talk about this a little bit in all of those videos to, you know, just to inform you guys in case you didn't know about that. But yeah, that's the way that YouTube is right now. Even though if you have subscribed to a channel and you are obviously expecting to see all the videos that the channel is uploading, it's not guaranteed if you are not interacting with the channel by leaving likes and comments as well. So that's the sad point of YouTube right now. And I also wanted to mention that if you still want to continue watching, if you want to make sure that you will catch all the updates, all the new videos for my channel, make sure to click that little bell icon that's next to my name. When you look below this video, you can see my name and the subscription or the subscribe button. Next to it is a little bell icon. And that's something that will enable email notifications. And even though it's really annoying, at least I don't really enjoy any email notifications personally, but that's the way that YouTube is now. So you would be able to get at least notifications to your email that I've been posting videos. Or the other really good option is to follow my Twitter. You don't have to have your own Twitter to be able to see my Twitter page, but you can check my Twitter and see when new videos have been posted, and you can keep up with the videos that way. But yeah, anyway guys, I feel like it was really, really rambly, but that has been something that has been on my mind recently, and I really need to figure out what I want to do with the channel, how I want to continue going. I don't want to stop doing any of my main series, not this series, not Time Shot, not Sims 2, or any of that. So I just need to figure out what to do with that, because it's really discouraging to see all these changes, the fact that you can't even, I mean, seriously, you can't even see all the videos that you are subscribed to. So that's definitely not a good thing, at least in my opinion. But anyway guys, yeah, enough rambling. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed this episode. I will continue tweaking that little ice cream stand and figure out what else I want to do with the DaVinci mod. It's really cool that we have a lot of options. We have a lot of creative freedom what we want to do with that mod. So I'm really, really excited about that. So we are going to end it here. So thanks so much guys for watching. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like and comment below. Like I said, say hi in the comments. And I will see you next time in Miranda.